I know there's pain.
Why do you lock yourself up in these chains?
No one can change your life except for you.
Don't ever.
Hi everyone, this is Kayla here, back for another video. In this video, I'm going to talk about my experience with being a special ed. So what this video is going to be about. Now, I was always a special ed growing up. And when I was 3 or 4, I was diagnosed with having my own mental retardation. And so I was put in special ed because of it. Before I start, I just want to say I'm grateful with, you know, for all the teachers that have, you know, done so much for me being a special ed, and you know, it helped me here and there. And just because I didn't have the best experience, I still appreciate all the teachers that have helped me throughout my experience being a special ed, so I just want to put it out there. But I was always like the odd one out, and the reason why I say that is because I have cerebral palsy, and cerebral palsy is a physical disability. And so, a lot of the kids, well, all the kids had mental disabilities. And so, the fact that I had a physical disability, I was extremely small, and I am really small. So therefore, I was always the odd one out. They basically didn't know what hurt me because they just didn't have enough resources. Because in special ed, they only teach up to 4th grade level. And so, every year, my parents would have a meeting, an IEP meeting, and they would be like, we don't know what to do with her. We don't know what to do with Kaylee because she's just really small. And so, because I was always really small, I didn't get the education I really needed. I truly didn't know that I really didn't need to be interested until I was in 6th grade. Whenever in grade school, I was put in special ed, and then I had like my regular class, but it would be like math, and so the special teacher would give me math. So I would do the stuff that I was given. Well, in 6th grade, I went out of the first 2 weeks of school. I would literally grab a book and grab a book, I'm serious, like grab a regular math book and start learning like everyone else. And I'm not kidding you, like, I literally did that. So, I knew something was always off, like, I just didn't know, like, why I was in special ed after that. I knew something was wrong when I was about 11. Like, I didn't know what, I just knew, like, why in the world am I getting a book, you know what I mean? Like, one of them, like, what else? And I really truly did. Like, I didn't want to have the type of math that my math teacher was giving me. I wanted to work on, like, the other kids, like, the other students. Like, I know that sounds odd, but because I'm really smart, that's probably why I took summer school. And I'm like, I wanted to be talented in math. Like, I wanted to be more talented. I really, really did. And I think it was because in 6th grade of that incident of me wanted, you know, did math like everyone else for those 2 whole weeks. And so I wanted to, you know, I wanted to get talents. Like, I knew that I just didn't fit in, you know? And so I said, I cried, and I just want to have one of the math. I wanted to be talents, and they did. So, 7th grade school year came, and I got moved to a different school. I was put in a classroom that was self-detained, and I kind of went backwards. Like, I ended up going backwards, just being really lazy, didn't really want to be in that type of class. Didn't want to be self-detained. I wanted to be mainstream. Well, they refused to put me in a class. Like, I was having a whole experience in that school, and that school really just put me backwards. So I really wasn't in a mainstream setting like I was in my other school. Like I said before, I was in special ed and then I was in my other class, but I had math like my special ed teacher would give me. Well, I was just self-detained, and I was in a self-detained setting, and I went backwards because of it. So after that year, I moved to a different school. And in that school, I was in a special ed program as well, but just kind of went to different classes. And I was more challenged than I've been, which was good. I was in the highest math class, and I was taught everything I needed to be taught to do algebra in that too. So that was really cool. I really enjoyed that school. The special ed program at the school was a really good special ed program. My freshman year, I was in special ed again. I had some electives that I took, and through high school, I took, 3D design and dance. Those were my two electives I took. But other than that, I didn't have any mainstream classes like math, English, science, history, any of that. I told my teacher that was doing math. I was taught everything I needed to be taught to go to an algebra class. And I knew that the math teacher I had taught a higher math, and I knew I could do it because I was taught all the skills I needed to be taught to do algebra. But no, instead of being put in algebra, I was put in life skill math. I did my best to be like advocate for myself, to be like, I need to be put in this class. And I went in sophomore year, I told my advisor, I need to be put in, I want to be talents. Like, I want to be put in a math class that I want to be talents. And she's like, oh, well, you get, hard on math. It was more life skill math. And I'm like, are you serious? And it was just horrible because, math is always my strong subject. I haven't done math for 12 years, like real math in 12 years, because of it. So all through high school, I never did like actual math. I did life skill math, which is like skills you need to be on your own type thing. So, it wasn't really math. And I was just never telling. I was always told what I couldn't do. and I know I was 16 years old or 15 years old, and my teacher, my special teacher, was like, she wanted us, you know, she sat down with us, like, you know, we sat and we talked about, like, what our disabilities are. And so, like, why we was in the classes. Basically telling us it would be too hard. And, I remember one time I was sitting on the bus, and she saw, like, you know, the reason why you're in these classes is because you guys have mental retardation. And I go, I don't have a mental disability. I have a fatal disability. And she's all like, who said that, you know? And I'm like, I did. I still myself. A special teacher should never call a student mentally retarded. And basically she called me that. And it's hopeful. I'm sorry, but no one should ever call you that. And I just, it's wrong. And at my senior year of high school, I took the AIMS. It was like modified AIMS, so it wasn't really AIMS that, you know, regular ed students would take. And I have taken the regular AIMS. I took the regular AIMS in sixth grade. I took it at a double grade level, but I took the regular AIMS and I did really good in that. And I passed all three of them in sixth grade. But in my senior year, I took modified AIMS. And so I went at my IEP meeting. They told me, you know, I did good, what have you, with my AIMS, and that reading, I went above and beyond. Now I went above and beyond in reading, and let me tell you, it wasn't because of the teachers. It had nothing to do with the teachers. And the reason why I say this is because my senior year, we did reading, but we did it like on like video tape. So we would like listen to a tape, and then basically like we wasn't really like reading. We would just like listen to the tape, you know, following along. And but the reason why my reading was so high, I would literally go and go to the library, get books, and sit there and read for hours and hours and hours and hours. And that's how my reading got better and better and improved and went beyond. And that's why my reading got so better, so good. It wasn't because of the teachers. It was because I challenged myself, I put myself. And that's the thing, sometimes, you know, you know if something's wrong, and I always knew something was wrong. But again, you're probably wondering, why didn't you try to say something to teachers? Why didn't you try to tell them the Indian mainstream? Well, that's really hard to tell a teacher that I need to be mainstream. For one, I never got the indication I needed, so that would be more harder just to be put in a mainstream, because they don't teach you the things that you need to be taught, so you can go to mainstream, so you can get out of special ed and actually be mainstream. So I've never taught those skills until this semester of being in college. So before then, I was never taught those skills I needed to be taught. So it's not an easy task to be like, well, and advocate for myself and tell those teachers, hey, I need this and this and this. Because one, I was a minor, so I had no say in my education. I was really, really limited on what I was able to be taught. I was really limited. I didn't have the say as to what I need to be taught, what are teaching me, and this and that. And back in December, my advisor like, now you know that in college they don't modify things. And I go, well, you'll never be able to learn if you modify things. And that is so true. I never learned the things I needed because everything was modified for my liking. Everything was modified for me to make things easier for me. But at the end of the day, you modified everything for that child. That child was never going to learn. So that's the thing too that special teachers need to learn, is that you modify things for children, everything, every little thing, they're never going to learn. And every student with a disability can learn. So therefore, I feel like the special system needs to challenge students little by little so they can be mainstream. When I graduated, I was at a first grade level in English. I was at a fourth grade level in reading, probably go to fourth, and then I was at a fourth grade level in math, probably low than that. My experience in being dismissed. And this license video, give it a thumbs up. If you guys want to subscribe. If you guys want to comment. If you guys want to share this video as well. And thank you so much for watching, and I love you guys. I mean, it'll be unique, different, special, and only unique ways. And bye, see you next time.